Hello everyone, welcome to the class. Today we are going to talk about sexual reproduction in flowering plant. We have already discussed about the first step of sexual reproduction, that is pollination. Now we are going to discuss about fertilization. So as we were talking about the flowering plant, that is angiosperms, so we have taken the pistil part of it. This is the pistil, carpel, or we can call it as gynoecium, a female reproductive part. Okay, so during the pollination, pollen grain, they are going to be transferred from anther to stigma. So now they are landed over here on the stigma of the pistil. Okay, pollen grains landed. This stigma is moist, it is sticky, it will provide nourishment to grow that pollen grains. Pollen grains will take the nourishment from the stigma and they will going to germinate to form the pollen tube. As you can see, this is the starting of the germination of pollen tube and here the complete pollen tube is formed. What this pollen tube is going to do? This pollen tube is acting as a passage for taking the male gamete to the female gamete. Okay, so over here this bigger cell is the egg cell and this egg cell is a female gamete. Got it? Now we'll see in this pistil, this swollen part is ovary. This is the embryo sac, which is going to contain the different cells, gamete, isi gandha present. Okay, this is embryo sac. This embryo sac is containing 7 cells, 1, 2, 3, 3 antipodal cells, 1 central cell and 3 cells are over here. Out of these 3, 2 are synergids and 1 is egg cell. So total 7 cells and you can see 8 nucleus. 3 nucleus, 2 and these are 3, so total 8. So in the case of embryo sac, seven cell and 8 nuclei are present. Okay, 7 cell stages. Fine. Now we'll see the procedure of fertilization. When the pollen grains, they fall on the stigma, they'll form the pollen tube. In this, there is a male gamete. So this will going to divide mitotically to form 2 male cells. Okay, so 2 male gametes are formed. These male cells will reach, travel karengi aur yaha par aajengi. And they are going to burst. Ye jaise hi iske end pe pahunchega, this is going to get ruptured and will release these male gametes into this embryo sac. First male gamete will fuse with the egg cell. This egg cell get fertilized by the nuclei of the male gamete and this process is called syngamy. So over here the first, as it is double fertilization, so twice the fertilization will occur. First fertilization is between egg cell and one male cell. And what they are going to form? They are going to form zygote. And this process is fertilization or syngamy, first fertilization. Second, the male gamete which is released into this embryo sac, the second one will reach to the central cell and fuse with the central cell. So already 2 nucleus are there, this is the third nuclei of this male gamete and here 3 nuclei are going to fuse. So this is the second fertilization which is termed as triple fusion. In the triple fusion, 2 polar nuclei present in the central cell plus one male cell nuclei. And what they are going to form? They are going to form endosperm, primary endosperm. Okay, this is primary endosperm cell. This is primary endosperm cell. So as it is a double fertilization, the process which is the characteristic of flowering plant, in which the male gamete is going to fertilize two cells in the embryo sac. One is the egg cell, the female gamete, to form zygote, and the second is the central cell, triple fusion, three nuclei get fused, that's why triple fusion, to form the primary endosperm cell, which will make endosperm a nutritive tissue. And zygote will make embryo, which will give rise to the future plant. So this is all about the double fertilization. Thank you.